Hello everyone, my name is Derrick and I'm a GMAT test prep expert here at Magoosh, and we're going to talk about the GMAT Quant section today. The GMAT Quant section is 31 questions, and really, in a vacuum, many test takers, I would say almost practically all, can answer any of these questions without breaking a sweat. But what the GMAT said is, let's make this a lot more interesting. And they stuck a timer up there, 62 minutes now to answer 31 questions. That gives you a little over 2 minutes to answer each question. That's a bit more of a challenge. One thing you don't want to get focused on is thinking that the GMAT is a math test, or even a verbal test for that matter. The GMAT is really a test focused on our executive reasoning skills. The GMAT wants to know, if given a challenge with a limited amount of time, how would you perform? Will you take the necessary route of going through all of the calculations, or will you know the shortcuts necessary to get to that answer and move on to the next question? In this video, we're going to talk about the 5 tips that you need to successfully conquer the GMAT Quant section. Tip number one, pacing. The GMAT Quant section is 31 questions and you have 62 minutes to solve these questions. The funny thing about the GMAT is that the math on the GMAT isn't that challenging. Most of the math on the GMAT is high level high school work, maybe a bit of touch of work from middle school and a few years of high school. But with the GMAT being a time intensive test and you have 2 minutes to solve each question, you cannot spend too much time making laborious calculations. With the GMAT, you have to have executive reasoning. You have to see a problem, think about a few ways of solving it, and then putting that plan to action. And then knowing, like the song says, know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away. After you worked on a problem and you see you're going past that 2 minute mark, it's time to jump away from that problem, cut bait, select an answer and move on. The GMAT pacing is super important to really conquering quant. You want to set up your paper properly and give yourself those allotted time marks to be successful on the exam. We've included a few more links to videos and to actual articles by Magoosh GMAT experts such as myself to really help you give a deeper dive on pacing and how important it is to the GMAT. Tip number two, know the core to solidify your floor. You have to take the time to understand the concepts of the GMAT Quant section thoroughly. The GMAT looks for those type of test takers that say, hey, for prep, I'm just going to study 700 level questions and that's it. Ain't wrong. The GMAT will penalize you for that. The GMAT will give you a very intensive exponent question and you've mastered that, but then hit you with a very nuanced question about inequalities that focuses on the principles and the fundamentals that underline that type of question. Like Jay-Z's homie told him, like my homie Strip told me, dude, finish your breakfast. You gotta do your breakfast. You gotta know the core. The basic fundamentals of quant is what's gonna cap your downside and give you all the upside potential. So if you understand thoroughly the principles of exponents, you understand triangles, you understand circles, you understand ratios, these are going to give you the opportunity to create a solid floor that will cause you to do two, that will prevent you from doing two things. One, doing laborious calculations on questions that you could solve by just looking at if you really know the basics and fundamentals. Two, it prevents you from making silly errors. And silly errors run amok on your score. As you aim for the highest score that you can, silly errors will cost you that. And the one way to prevent errors is to have a solid foundation when you can just look at a problem and know what are the traps. And that comes from knowing the foundation. And again, like I said, know the core to solidify your floor. Tip three, math is not a spectator sport. You can't sit around and look at it. Magoosh has a lot of great videos. Even I get caught up sometimes thinking that I know a concept because I watch the video and then I do that practice test and I get rocked. And then you're at the practice test thinking to yourself like, oh man, I've seen this before. Oh man, I did this before. And you didn't do it. You watched it. You watched it happen. I watch Steph Curry shoot 3-pointers all day. That doesn't mean I can do it. I have to go out there and practice the skill. Be respectful of the art. Go out there and do the work. Give yourself 20 problems. Knock them out. Time yourself. You have to be involved with the math daily. You have to really take the time to focus on doing the problems. Now, many students will say, hey, I've done all the problems in the OG. Okay, why don't you do them again and do them all in a different way? You have to get better at solving the problems in a clear, efficient way. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is actually putting pencil, pen, or marker to paper or laminate and really solving the problem. Getting comfortable setting up your paper. Physically moving your hand is another way of engaging your brain in deeper thought. This will pay off dividends when you come to the actual test day and have to work out all these problems on paper. Tip number four, know the strategies. Plugging in numbers, backwards solving, doubling and halving. These strategies and a lot more will really help boost your score on the GMAT quant section. Often, I get students that come from maybe a math background or just feel really confident in their computational skills. And they could see a problem and then start doing all of these advanced calculations to get to a problem that could have easily been solved with backward solving. Let me tell you one thing about the test. No one sees your scratch paper. So you don't have to worry ever about thinking that you won't get a high score because your scratch paper is not filled up with a bunch of marks. Think smart. Be efficient. You are a business leader of tomorrow. It's not about wasting your time on problems that could be solved like that. We're thinking innovation. We're thinking smart. We're thinking moving forward. You are some of the brightest people in the world. Think about simple ways to solve complex problems. It's a way of changing your perspective on the GMAT and having a perspective more as a business leader, executive, because you will be that as an MBA student, and thinking about ways to solve this problem. Don't take it personal. Don't go to the exam thinking that you have to prove something to anyone. You are good enough just the way you are. So think about the strategies that you can use that can help you circumvent some of those time-sinking, heavily intensive calculations that you may believe you have to know, and use a shortcut. There's nothing wrong with thinking about a problem in a different way. Instead of a calculation, maybe draw a picture. Instead of getting an exact answer in math, use estimation. All of these strategies are at your fingertips. It's just you, your scratch paper, and the computer. No one has to know how you got the right answer, but just get the right answer. The GMAT doesn't give you any credit for showing your work. So get the answer the best way you can and fight for it, because you deserve to earn that great score that you set out to go get. Tip number five. I put this at the last tip because a lot of people may skip to the end. And I understand we're in a skimming world. A lot of people like to just get to the nitty gritty. I put this at tip number five, but it's the most important one that I see. It's the power of the error log. If you want to be successful in the GMAT quant, you have to have pacing. You have to know the core foundations. You have to have a great development of doing the problems. You also have to think about alternate strategies, but you could sum all this up together by creating a high quality error log. The error log is super important. It's one of the tools that you don't have to pay much for, but could give you a lot of value if you respect and treat it like you need to. The error log needs to be visited. It's like a pet, right? You can't just go outside and party and not worry about your pet at home. You may come home and they may still be hungry. You have to spend the time with the error log. Take the time and energy and effort to make a quality error log. And this is done in a few steps. We have links to more detailed analysis of an error log and how to create it. But here's a few things you should think about after you completed a problem. What went right? What went wrong? Why did I make that decision? What's a better way to approach it next time? And the fifth key one is, when will I do this problem again? Too many times, students come, they complete the entire OG. back and forth. They even get old OGs. I had one student have an official guide from 2004, and they completed them all. And they said that after they've done this problem, all they've had was just a tired wrist and a bunch of marks in a book. I said, we have to take a more strategic approach. It's about learning from our past mistakes, developing those powerful behaviors, and the error log will do just that. So those are my five tips on how to be successful in the GMAT quant section and really take your score to the next level. Let's bring them all together. Pacing, make sure you understand that each question, you have to make a decision quickly if you can solve this problem and go down the path or skip and guess. The second idea, make sure you understand you need to know the fundamentals. Don't worry about those 700 level questions. You will get there soon enough, but it's those 400, 500, 600 level questions that are pivotal for you to advancing on to the next round. Third, do the work. It's one thing to watch the video. The videos are great. I love watching the videos myself, but you will never learn the concept and the thoroughness that you need to until you actually put pen to paper and get that work done. Number four, focus on the strategies. Understand the various ways to solve a problem in efficient ways. You solve the problem in 3 minutes, now solve it in 2 minutes, now solve it in 1 minute. You gotta think game time scenarios. Not every time you're gonna have a whole 2 minutes to solve a problem. Sometimes you get down to three questions left and you have 2 minutes. What are the quick ways you can eliminate problems and boost your possibility, the opportunity, and the greater chance for you to get that answer right? Again, and then number five, understand the error log, the power of the error log. It's a low cost, high touch tool that could really drive your score to the next level. If these tips were helpful, like the video. Also, drop a hello in the comment section. We'd love to hear from you. And if you want to hear more about the GMAT and the test prep options Magoosh has to offer, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Until then, stay up and stay sharp.